In some neighbourhoods of Detroit, it looks like a hurricane has recently swept through, destroying nearly everything in its path. And in a sense, that's exactly what has happened here. Only this disaster is an economic one. The US recession has hit Detroit so badly that thousands of houses are being left to rot as residents default on their mortgages, are forced from their homes and move away.
But once that house goes vacant, the aluminum disappears, the copper disappears, the siding's all gone, the gutters are gone. They might be a little bigger, a little smaller, a little newer, but there's thousands and thousands of these.
A local estate agent explains that banks won't pay to fix up houses, so they're being shoved back into a dead market at astonishingly low prices.
It's at that point right now.
Well, on this particular block, over 50-60% of the houses are either missing or already in foreclosure. This particular house is at $50 right now. We're starting to see a lot of houses fall well below $1,000. Prices of $500 or less are commonplace.
In a city that's home to the ailing US car industry, hard times aren't anything new for Detroit. The abandoned factories and shuttered public buildings bear testament to decades of a city's steady economic decline. Infrastructure like Detroit's main train station has fallen into disrepair after years of standing idle. But the fear now is that any hope of revival is quickly being lost.
The last time these ticket booths were in action was January 1988, when the last train pulled out of Michigan Central Station. Since then, there have been numerous plans to refurbish this Detroit landmark, but now, as the economic crisis starts to bite here more than anywhere, it looks like those plans may never come to fruition.
Nearly 1,000 people a month are now thought to be leaving Detroit in search of better opportunities. The central downtown area at rush hour feels like a ghost town. And local journalist John Carlisle says residents are under no illusions about their city's future.
You know, in the park we're in right now, we're surrounded by 30-story skyscrapers that are abandoned, which you don't really see anywhere else. You might see one, but you don't see six or seven right around you. And this is technically, we're sitting right in the city center. It's definitely gotten worse over the years, and it's hard to see how they're going to reverse it.
The slow and painful death of a once great American metropolis. As the recession deepens, other US cities will be hoping Detroit isn't a sign of things to come. Sebastian Walker, Al Jazeera, Detroit.